Stories about heroes are as old as stories themselves. The oldest story we have on record is the Epic of Gilgamesh, all about the king of heroes who called people mongrels, or at least so I assume. Then followed more stories, ones about King Arthur, and then Spider-Man, and then Naruto, and then Fate Clade, and probably a few others as well, but they don't matter today. But today, I want to bring you a new tale of heroes. The webcomic of, wait, what was it called again? Oh wait, title of the video, Aura. Aura is the story of a young man by the name of Kaze, who is of course the hero of this story. He has red hair to symbolize how hot-blooded he is, how he will take on every challenge that comes his way, and how he will save the world. And his Imoto. Imoto means little sister, by the way. Or maybe his red hair is just because the author thought it was cool. Or maybe it's actually indicating a plot twist later on. It's not like I can just ask the author or anything. Anyway, Kaze must learn how to use the power of Aura to fight the evil in the world after his sister is taken hostage. He also learns how to use the power of Aura to go get pizza, because that is the true power that binds generations together. Aura is a true masterpiece of entertainment. It knows it is a web manga. The reader knows it is a web manga. It knows the reader knows that it knows that the president likes Twitter too much. Good or bad, I'll let you decide. We're not getting into politics today. And because of that, Aura is able to do the impossible. Mark my words, it will open a hole in the universe, making a path for those behind us, the dreams for those who have fallen, the hopes of those who will follow, and those two sets of dreams will become a double helix, drawing a path towards tomorrow. That is Aura. Or maybe Garlockan. Or maybe both. Whatever the case, Aura is clearly inspired by the fun and ridiculousness of shonen manga and anime, something I can't help but love. Maybe that is because I'm listening to the Promised Neverland OST right now, and that is a good OST and a shonen and awesome. But yes, Aura is filled with what you expect from shonen. The training arcs, the power, over-the-top hairstyles, all embracing what has come before. But while one may see only a derivative work, a closer look will tell you that this is a masterpiece for the ages. Starting in chapter 72, we begin to understand Kaze's past, how it shaped him into the man he is. Not just an independent hero, but one who fate had called to embrace the truth of people dying when they are killed. Through the next 69 chapters, we go through a deconstruction, followed by a reconstruction of the fundamental beliefs of storytelling. We question what a story is, what it is meant to be, and it is as if we, as readers, are actually the fictional characters in these characters' minds. Kaze is forced to learn that no matter what special powers he may have, he is still only human. No more and no less. Chapter 117 puts it best when Kaze finds himself in a hospital he did not remember existing, and where his arch-rival Shite is a nurse. Kaze is forced to question what he fights for, what he believes, but then he learns the truth, and sets the entire hospital on fire, along with a nearby orphanage, and follows his dream of proving that Santa is in fact a fallen hero, joined by his best friend, Phil. And like all great web entertainment of the written and drawn form, Aura has 12 arcs, the perfect number. I'm also quite a fan of chapter 229, though you'll just have to read that part for yourself. True, I mean, chapter 242 is kind of weird with that whole flaming flamingo thing, but when Goku did the fourth sacred rite four chapters later, it all made sense. Well, if you ignore those three laws of physics anyway. So I hope you'll check out Aura. And not just because this video is sponsored by the creator of Aura, who threatened to submit fake copyright notices if I didn't review it and say good things about it. Nope, that totally did not happen at all. Nor is I bribed with potatoes. Nor tacos. Those things definitely didn't happen. So yes, happy April 1st, everyone, in case you actually took any of this seriously. But yeah, go check out Aura, go check out Kagami, and I will see you all next time.